Welcome to another episode of What's Hot in Hip Hop Videos and Reviews. My name is Jeffrey Blackfoot, the founder and chairman of WhatsHotInHipHop.com. Today I'm going to be showing you some video footage of a comedian by the name of Katt Williams. He was interviewed on Club Shay Shay, hosted by Shannon Sharpe. And I gotta tell you, Katt Williams, he exposed a lot of people like Ricky Smiley, Tyler Perry, P. Diddy, Cedric the Entertainer. Well, let's take a look at that video footage and then we'll come back and we'll discuss it. Let's take a look.
Have you ever been booed, Katt?
Yes. Yeah. I have.
What was that feeling like? Did it like want to give up? I don't know how early it was in your career. Obviously, it hadn't been in the, I don't think it's in the last decade because you've been immaculate.
Have you ever dropped a pass?
I have. I've been booed too.
You know the little segment between everything is fine and I got it, and then you noticing where it is now?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's that. The thing about as a comedian, the audience's opinion is the only opinion that matters, not you, the writer, not none of that. And so I don't think any comedian has ever been booed unnecessarily either.
they deserve it.
Oh, yeah. I'm saying, what do they say when a guy shoots the air ball in the NBA? They say, air ball, right, to make sure everybody knows. But again, he still got to get back on D.
Right.
Won't work with Ricky Smiley again unless he's in a dress. Now, what was Ricky Smiley's next movie? Was it First Sunday? Did he wear a dress in it? You bet he did. It's in my contract.
Why would you put that in your contract, Katt?
That's where he's a believable actor. Him and Tyler Perry can't play a man to save their life. They play good women, and I believe that the best actor should be in the best role.
So that's why, because when we released that clip and he said that, you responded because he said he was supposed to play Money Mike and you were supposed to play Santa Claus.
An outright lie. So that he knows is a lie.
So why would he say it?
Because he's a liar. Nobody knows why liars lie. And that's why I had to come on the program. Cedric did the same thing. Cedric told you when you asked him, did you steal Katt Williams' joke?
Yeah.
He said, it don't line up. How it don't line up that I did it on TV in 2018? You came to see me at the Comedy Store do it in 2019 and then did it on the Kings of Comedy. Like, what doesn't line up? This is a televised joke that Mark Curry helped me punch up and get to the level that it was. The same Steve that went to go watch Mark Curry do his whole sitcom and then stole everything Mark Curry had. Now Steve got a sitcom where he the principal and he wear a suit and he... And then he gets this high top fade, making all black men think he got the best lineup in the business. And it's a man unit. Then you ask it, why you not a movie star? I didn't want to be a movie star. This the same Negro that hated on Bernie with this same thing. I didn't want to be a movie star. No, you couldn't be a movie star. There are 30,000 new scripts in Hollywood every year. Not one of them asks for a country bumpkin black dude that can't talk good over cable and look like Mr. Potato Head. There ain't none. You would have to have range. What happened? Like, no, not they offered him $50 million and he turned it down. Who gonna turn down $50 million? Now, I've had to turn down $50 million four times. Four times. Just to protect my integrity and that virgin hole I was telling you about. Right. Because P. Diddy be wanting the body. And you gotta tell him no. You got to tell him no.
I did.
See, I got the receipts for everything I'm telling you. That's why I can say them.
So welcome back. I mean, did you see how Katt Williams exposed all those comedians? I mean, Katt Williams, he was in Friday After Next. He was in a movie called First Sunday. I think those was produced by Ice Cube. And the response that was circulating over the internet from those comedians that Katt Williams pretty much put on blast, they pretty much just said that Katt was crazy, but they never denied what he was saying. And so that's a little suspect if you ask me. But what I need you to do is I need you guys to drop some comments. Let's continue this conversation. I wanna get more into depth and what you feel. Did you think Katt Williams was telling the truth, or was he just fabricating these stories? I'm curious in hearing your opinion. And that being said, I just would like to thank everybody for tuning in to another episode of What's Hot in Hip Hop Videos and Reviews. That link to the YouTube channel is WHIHH Video. Don't forget to subscribe. Click on that bell button so you can be notified. Don't forget to follow us on all of our other social media platforms. And don't forget to check out our website, whatshotinhiphop.com. And don't forget to submit those videos to the website so we can showcase your video for you. That's our way of giving back to the hip-hop and R&B community. I'm going to leave you with these important words. Don't forget to build a relationship with the Lord. It's so important. You'd be surprised how far the Lord can take you if you just trust in Him. That being said, thank you for watching, and be safe out there.